to another HRO Today educational podcast. In this series, we aim to provide you the latest workforce management approaches and best practices in HR. I'm Debbie Bola, Editorial Director of HRO Today magazine. One question facing HR leaders today is, how can their organizations become an employer of choice? And more research supports that providing a good candidate experience during the recruiting and hiring processes is an important factor. A good candidate experience can provide a glimpse into the culture of the organization and can leave potential hires with a good impression. And with that comes many benefits. In fact, recent research finds that 82% of job seekers would share a positive candidate experience among their peers. So how do candidates define a positive experience? According to research from the 2018 North American Candidate Experience Research Report, top talent is looking for an easy, informative process aided by technology. And today's HR technology can certainly improve many steps, making applying, connecting, scheduling, and onboarding easier. But with so many different options in the marketplace, where should HR leaders begin? Today, I have an expert here with me to offer some perspective. Ron Walters is Senior Managing Partner at endevis. Endevis RPO strives to deliver substantial results with quality never being sacrificed for speed. The organization works seamlessly as the recruiting extension of its partners, attracting, connecting, and matching individuals with positions to create successful experiences for candidates and clients alike. Ron, thank you for being here today. I mentioned some research around the impact of a positive candidate experience. Why do you think organizations need to consider the candidate experience in their recruiting strategies?
Here at endevis, we believe the candidate experience defines everything as it relates to the relationship that an applicant is going to have with an organization. There's a lot of research out there that shows that individuals that have great experiences are more open to reconsidering things such as pay, the role that they take on, or even the location of the role. It also shows that people have more positive experience, they're likely to refer their friends, or they're going to promote the organization that they've just gone to work for through their social media channels. They're more likely to engage within the organization when they move into the organization as a new employee, and so that in turn reduces turnover. So we also tell organizations that the candidate experience does not end after they're hired. Keep that experience going through to make sure that they get connected and take on your organization's philosophies and views.
And so how can technology help in this process?
You know, that is a great question because technology plays such a big role in everything today. And we believe that technology is very vital in creating a great candidate experience. There's so much out there. I think organizations need to look and say, what's best for my organization? But here's some of the things that we utilize. First off, AI tools are great. And I know there's a lot of different AI tools that are out there. I encourage people to go and look for those tools that best fit who they are. But we look at AI tools such as Maya, for an example. It is a great tool. But in addition to that, we also look at video because we think that video is a great way that individuals consume information. So besides the chat bots and things of that nature, there's the videos. We've created organizational videos. So it's a video that talks about an organization and why it's a great place to work and why it'd be a great experience for the individual. We also provide people with candidate expectation videos, and that is a video that says, here's the process that you're going to go through from the time you apply to the job to the point in time to where you're going to accept that role. And that's been very helpful in creating great experiences, along with position description videos that are very simple and easy. After the position description video runs, there's an opportunity right there on that video to point and click and go into the apply. But then there's something that we've done this year that we've find to be really cool. We're hoping that it takes hold. We are introducing to our clients a personal video for applicant when the night before or a couple days before an interview, they'll receive a video from one of our recruiters that just says, hey, thank you for accepting the interview with the organization. We want to talk to you about a couple things to go over to make sure you're well prepared for your time. Just goes into the checklist of things for people to think about prior to going into the interview. And our belief is this, is sometimes people might get a little nervous about an interview. We want to make sure that there's something there that they can say, oh, yeah, I do remember that. Once again, it creates a better experience for the individual. And the foundation to that piece there, too, is this. We want to communicate with applicants or with people through their favorite channels of social media or through their favorite channel of communicating. So if their favorite way to communicate is through text messaging, we'll do text messaging. If it's through a Facebook or a LinkedIn, we'll do that. If it's through some other type of an app, if it's a Snapchat, an Instagram, a WhatsApp, or any other method of communication, we're going to do that because what we really encourage our clients to do is to make sure that you always look at it from the perspective of what's going to make a great experience for the candidate, and that's what we want to do. We want to make it easy for them.
Those are some good examples of making the experience feel really customized to the candidate. So how will this help recruiters and just improve the overall process in general?
We feel it helps recruiters with the overall process. First off, all of this automation that's taking place, these videos, it gives the recruiter the ability to be more transparent, more communicative. It really promotes honesty throughout the process, and honesty promotes trust. Trust helps what is foundational to experiences. So by a recruiter having these tools, being more accountable, they're also improving their own brand. What we've seen through the automation and how it's helped the candidate experience is it allows our recruiters to be more timely with the process. They're managing a tremendous amount of information, more information than they used to manage, but they're managing it easier. Why? Because they have these tools that are there, automated screens, automated scheduling of interviews, automation in updates through chatbots. So it allows recruiters to really focus on speaking to the applicants who are best qualified for the role and to make sure that, that those applicants are moving into the best roles. We believe that this really is very helpful to help recruiters improve the overall process and really begin the creation of that great experience for that individual coming through the process.
Now, can you provide some specific benefits of using automation and technology for organizations?
Sure. We recently engaged with a client. They're a relatively unknown organization. They only had about 130 employees. They're in the managed care space, and they're a startup, and they needed to fill 250 roles in 6 weeks. And these weren't like 250 roles that were, there was a large populations of people that might exist in these locations. These are RN case managers, nurse practitioners, licensed social workers, renal dietitians, community health care workers. They needed people quickly, and they needed the 250 offers in 6 weeks. And so we had to sit down with them, and first off, we realized speed was important and having people with the right education was important. But we also knew that we had to make sure the experience was good because we knew that we had to move fast. And so in moving fast, we wanted to make sure that we were communicative to the applicant or the person all the way through the process. We knew that we had to have a great experience because it's a relatively unknown firm. So from a brand perspective, we had to make sure that all the information was there, that they could digest that information or consume that information. So we used video. We used process automation. We used some artificial intelligence. It helped us move a large number of people through a process very quickly. We were able to provide 300 accepted offers in 6 weeks. So we exceeded our goal by 20%. We went through that process, and we do surveying, and throughout that process, we did checkpoints. The candidate experience that the surveys brought back were very high. The acceptance rates on these roles were extremely high, allowing the client to exceed their expectations or the needs that they had, and it's working out for the client. So it's very important that you have the tools in place and you look at the automation, and the most important thing is make sure you look at things from the perspective what's best for the applicant, what's going to be easy for the applicant.
It sounds like technology could have a big impact in that situation. Now, I think a good place to end today would be talking about some best practices for organizations to use when looking to improve their candidate experience.
Candidate experience is so important. What I always try to tell people is this, is let's not overthink it. Do what you think is right. Make sure it's an inbound approach, meaning you're making it easy for the applicant. You need to think like the applicant. So you need to review your process, make it easy. Think about the places where you can insert technology such as AI or video or some levels of automation that is going to make sure that the candidate moves through that with being a great experience and saying, this feels good. Make sure it's got the brand of your organization in there. So keep it simple. You know, have a big goal with small steps to get there that's going to create a better experience for every applicant that goes through. Things to think about, no matter where you are in the spectrum, maybe some organizations say, I really have nothing here in that particular area. And some organizations might be saying to themselves, I have a little, but I'd like to do something more. Here's what I would suggest. One would be, go to your applicant tracking system provider. Give them a call and talk about candidate experiences. Oftentimes what you'll find is they may have some tools already within your applicant tracking system that you could utilize to help you get really into creating great experiences through the use of technologies or through the use of videos. The other thing would be to go out and just look at information and articles as it relates to candidate experiences and look at that information, and do not be afraid to reach out to organizations and talk to them about what they do from a perspective of providing you with tools to help with the candidate experience. I know we work with a provider, they do the video for us, and what we really like about it is they're measuring every step of the way. And so when we look at those measurements and those metrics that they provide to us, and then we look at the surveying that we do, it allows us to tweak that process for our clients that we work with. And to me, that's just so important because we want to make sure that we are giving our clients every opportunity to get the greatest people out there to be in the right roles within their organization. But once again, it's also about the person or the applicant. And what we look at this is, can the individual move through that process easily? And what we have found is, keep it simple. I think that's the best way. And we think that technology offers a very simple, practical approach to create great candidate experiences.
Well, thank you, Ron, for providing some insight to creating a positive candidate experience and the ways to leverage technology. Until next time, listeners,